I'm Tammy Colda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. On this YouTube channel, I'm providing a detailed how-to guide on using TikZ and PGF plots. These videos are based on my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, as well as some bonus materials. Today's episode is based on a question from a watcher. The watcher wanted to know about creating number lines using TikZ. Number lines can be useful for student quizzes and handouts, as well as a first step in another diagram. I'll show two ways to create number lines, and then I'll give an example of showing open and closed sets on a number line. This is one of a series of videos on TikZ and PGF plots, so please check out the other videos on this channel to learn more. I've already created a starting point for us with a document preamble. The main requirement is the package TikZ. The other packages are just for convenience. I'm using parskip and full page here just to make things look nice. The hyperref package is so that I can link the author name back to the YouTube channel, as you see over here. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and draw a number line. Today, I'm going to make it from minus 10 to 10 with ticks at every integer. So let me go ahead and paste some code here. This is creating a TikZ picture environment, which is our drawing canvas. And then it's going to draw a line from minus 11 to positive 11. I'm giving a little extra space at each end. Let me go ahead and compile that. I've used two options here. One is thick, and that's to make the line a bit thicker. And then I'm using less than dash greater than, which says to put arrowheads at each end. Observe that this runs off the edge of the screen. So I could change these endpoints explicitly, but I'd rather just rescale the graphic itself. So I'm going to rescale the graphic to be 50% of its original size. By default, a unit in TikZ is 1 centimeter, so this changes a unit to instead be 5 millimeters. Now we can see it a lot better, and I can zoom in so we can see things a little more closely. Now let's add some tick marks. We can do this using a TikZ loop. I'll include a link to my episode on TikZ loops in the show notes. Here we have our loop. We're going to loop from minus 10 to 10 in intervals of 1, which it knows because I did minus 10, minus 9, dot, 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 10. And then it's drawing for each integer I from minus 0.1 to positive 0.1 in the y direction. So we get our little tick marks here. Now let's add some labels. If I add them at every tick mark, it'll be too crowded. So I'm just going to add them at every fifth tick mark. So this time I'm going to put in a loop that goes by intervals of 5. And so here we have minus 10, minus 5, dot, 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 10. And then we're going to put our nodes below with a small font at the position I minus 0.1. And that's the lower end of the tick mark. I've added a link to the episode on nodes in the show notes. Finally, to create extra space around the number line, I can actually enlarge the drawing canvas. Now, you could do this by just manually adding some space using VSpace or something in your LaTeX document. But another way to do it is to draw an invisible rectangle and make that the bounding box of the drawing. I'll include a link to my bounding boxes episode in the show notes. Meanwhile, here's the code to create this. So I'm drawing a rectangle from minus 11, 2, to 11, 2, and now that invisible rectangle is around this box and enlarges the canvas. That was just one way to draw a number line. Another way is to simply use the grid command. Let me paste some code here, and I'll show you how to do that. Here I'm just revealing the grid underneath the rectangle that I cut out. So I go from minus 11, minus 0.1, which is the point here, to 11, 0.1, which is the point there. And then I use the grid command in between, and that's basically showing the part of the grid that is underneath the rectangle. In this way, I get the ticks for free. The main downside is that I don't get arrows at the end, so if you want those, you'll want to do it the first way I showed. As before, I can add some tick labels and increase the size of the bounding box to make things have a little extra space in our drawing canvas. So there we get something very similar to what we had before. Finally, we can use the number line to display intervals. Let me paste some code here that draws a grid like we had before. Just for fun, I'm labeling every second tick rather than every fifth one. Suppose I wanted to draw the closed interval minus infinity to minus 2. I'll draw a red line that's ultra thick, and I'll have an arrow, which I indicate by this less than sign dash. By putting red by itself at the front, I've told that everything should be red, including the text, which is the node that we draw midway here from minus infinity to 2. We're saying in math what we did. Now, we should add something at minus 2 to indicate that the interval is closed. Before we do that, let's define a node style named closed that is a filled circle. I'll link to the episode on styles in the show notes. So here we're creating closed and we're saying it's a style with the slash dot style. We're making it a circle. The intercept is zero. That means we're taking away the excess space. We're going to draw it the outside. We're going to make it thick. We're going to make the minimum size to be 6 PT, and we're going to fill the node because this is a closed node. Now that we've defined that style, we can add a node at the end here. So I'm going to add a node at the very end. I still have the curly braces. Even though there's no text in the node, you're always required to have those curly braces. So now when I compile that, I get my closure point at the point minus two. Now let's define an open node type. It's basically the same as what we had. So we'll call this open, and then we do the slash dot style. We're going to use the closed style as before, and then we're going to add to the end of it that the fill is white, and that will make it filled with white. Now I can draw the open interval 6 to infinity. Let me paste that code here. I'm going to draw it in olive, and I'm going to draw it ultra thick. What I'm doing here in this little segment of code is I'm adding a node at position 0 that is an open style node. So we get this open circle there that's filled with white. I'm using that pause argument to indicate that it's at the start of the path. And you can have however many nodes you want and give them the pause arguments along the path to put them anywhere along the path that you want. Finally, let's draw an interval that is half closed and half open from 0 to 3 in blue. I placed the nodes a little differently here just to demonstrate the flexibility in this regard. I put the first node that's closed right at 0, 0, immediately following that declaration. I didn't have to say the position because it knows the position is right there. Then I put the node that goes over top. I specified that midway immediately after the dash dash. So you can put it here or you can put it after the closing point. And then finally, I put the closing point, which is an open node, at the position 3, 0. I didn't have to say the position because it's immediately following the coordinate. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Drawing intervals combines a lot of what we learned in TikZ. We'll likely come back to PGF plots in the next video. Let me know if there's anything special you'd like me to cover. There's a link to the Overleaf document we created today in the show notes. Please click like or subscribe if you want more videos like this. You can also buy my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, at your favorite book retailer. Thanks for watching.